Hi, everybody. Welcome to Awaken and Grow TV. I'm Christy Negro, spiritual teacher and clairvoyant. And today I wanted to introduce you to a yogic technique called Nadi Shodhan. And it's a breathing process that is known to create balance and to help cleanse the channels of the bodies. The nadis are the energy channels that run through the body. And it helps to oxygenate your system, and it also helps to provide clarity and reduce stress. So it's a great technique to have during the holidays or really any time that you are feeling anxious or overwhelmed or just want to ground and get yourself into a centered, clearer state of being. So before I show you the technique, I just want to talk a little bit about it. For those of you who don't know, I have my yoga teacher certification. I received it years ago. I lived in an ashram for a while and received my training there and my certification there. I had my own yoga studio for many years, taught about 11 classes a week, which was pretty awesome physically for my body. I loved it. And then I also have a traditional naturopath background. I have a degree in traditional naturopathy and also a master herbalist degree. So just for credentials sakes. So first of all, with this process, if you have high blood pressure or hypertension, it's recommended that you don't do it, because it can elevate your heart rate, I guess, or something along those lines. It's just not good to be controlling the breath in the way that you control it in this process. In it, we use the Vishnu Mudra in order to block off the nostrils. And the Vishnu Mudra is the right hand, and the index and the middle fingers reach down to touch the palm, and the ring finger and the pinky stay extended and your thumb is extended. So it is, this mudra is considered to be a receiving mudra, and I find it interesting because I actually find it challenging with the right hand to curl these fingers down. So it's something to play with because I think it says something about our ability to receive, right? If we're trying to do this and we are having a hard time extending the fingers down, there's a reason for that. And with everything with yoga, it's always telling you and teaching you and showing you about things that are going on in your own body and in your own space. So this is the mudra, okay? And it's alternate nostril breathing. You're breathing in through the right, out through the left, in through the left, out through the right. It energetically, it balances the left and right side. So our right side is our masculine energy. It's what we put out. It's our external dynamic. The left side is our internal feminine energy. It is the internal process, also what we give to ourselves. So we're bringing those two dynamics into balance. The process provides oxygenation to your body, which is always really great. So our heart and our kidneys work really hard to purify the blood and oxygenate our system. So anything that we can do to take off some of the pressure or stress of that process is really helpful. So bringing more oxygen in, it also helps to balance the pH of the body and bring you into that alkalinity state. In that alkalinity state, pretty much disease can't exist. So the more we alkalinize our system, the healthier we are, the better our immune system. It all works as one big whole. So let's go into our Vishnu Mudra. Here we go. And you're going to plug your right nostril with the thumb, and you're going to breathe in through the left, and then you plug the left nostril and breathe out through the right. You breathe in through the right, plug the right, breathe out through the left, breathe in through the left, plug the left, breathe out through the right. So we do this process ending on, so we start on the left, we end on the right. Traditionally, 10 minutes is a good time. If you can do 5 minutes, that's fine. You want to be sitting in a chair with your feet flat on the floor. You want to have your body straight. You don't want to be slumped over because we're bringing energy through the energy channels. So we want to help to provide this clear space. You can also sit on the floor cross-legged if that works for you. I always prefer to sit with my feet flat because my practice is to bring my spirit into my body to connect myself. And traditionally, that cross-legged mode takes the energy in a figure eight through the legs, shoots it up through the spine, and the intention was to leave the body to reach enlightenment above ourselves, because that was the path, the current state of our spiritual growth, was that our spirit lives slightly out of ourselves, and it was to reach it, and now spirit is trying to come in. That's the stage that we're in, and I'll talk about that in another episode, about the stages that we have gone through as in our spiritual evolution and the one that we're at right now, because it's actually really interesting information and it lends a lot to some of what's going on in the world. Okay, so let's do this. So we're gonna go back to our Vishnu Mudra. We're going to plug the right nostril and we're gonna breathe in through the left and out through the right. We're going to breathe in through the right and out through the left. Breathe in through the left, out through the right, and we'll stop there for a second. So when I do this, I envision or have this sense that the breath comes up, kind of arcs through my head, clears out any cobwebs that are in there, and comes back out through the right, and is constantly doing this sort of, you know, as it reaches up, as you're inhaling and it reaches up to that point, it sort of arcs and then it comes back down. So it's not like breathing in, stop, breathe out, stop, breathe in, stop. It's breathe in, let it arc up and come back down. So let's do that one more time. So right finger closes the left nostril. Excuse me. I've been talking a lot today. Okay. There we go. This is our Vishnu Mudra. Breathing in. And out through the right. Breathing in. And out to the left, breathing in, letting that breath arc up, and out to the right. Okay, so that is Nadi Shodhan. It is a pranayama technique, and it's fun to play with, or good to play with, to help you find balance and alignment and centered, balance the left and right. Balance our mind and our body, and just bring us into that place of clarity, and also just to release stress. So something you can do anywhere, you're sitting in your car, you're waiting in line, you're on a plane, right? It's always with us. Just remember, if you have hypertension or high blood pressure, this isn't a technique that you want to do. If you have other health issues and you're not sure, you know, definitely check in with your doctors. If you do get lightheaded while you're doing this, then just stop, bring yourself back to normal breath, and just try to build it up little by little, and wait till you know, find your balance before you get up and walk away from doing it. All right, if you have any questions, be sure to pop them in the comments wherever you happen to be watching. So YouTube, Facebook, those are good question places, places to leave questions. The website, Awakening Grow TV, you can leave questions there. If you're watching anywhere else, I would just suggest coming to one of those places and leave me a question, so that, or comment, so that I can interact with you. It's hard to manage the many, many different places where this streams. So yeah, I hope that this supports you during the holidays. I'll be back with some more pranayama techniques over the different episodes, and I'll definitely get an episode together to talk about the stages that we have gone through in our spiritual evolution as humans, because it's absolutely fascinating information. I love it. I love right where we're at right now. It all makes sense. And so I'll share that with you in another episode. All right. Thanks for joining me today, and I'll see you again soon.